L10 LED light, quarter inch microphone input. This is the gimbal I'm looking for.
What is shaking, everybody? Hopefully not your camera, because we're about to review a gimbal that is very innovative, and this is going to be a really important gimbal going forward, because this gimbal has a couple innovations that could lay out the groundwork for the possible gimbals we see in the future. So in this video, we're going to take a look at some of the innovations and see if Crane M3 has improved some of the problems that Crane M2 had. And as a quick disclaimer, this is not a pay review. In fact, June's gonna probably watch this video around the same time you guys are, so let's get to it. Now, I had this pre-production gimbal for about a month or so throughout the month, I tested this gimbal in a studio environment, as well as outside in the real world, so I actually took this gimbal out in the wedding. It's very, very tight. A lot of tight spaces, so perfect for this small gimbal, so you get to see some of the footage and I get to tell you about some of my experience from that. So this is gonna be like almost full review, because there are some features on this gimbal that are currently locked out because this is a pre-production model, so we'll talk about that in a little bit later. Now, this is an interchangeable multi-camera kind of gimbal. In fact, it comes with this really nice high quality phone holder for it, and you can also put GoPro on here. But to be honest, I think GoPro these days have such a good stabilization that you don't need a gimbal for it, and I actually use a lot of mirrorless cameras, so I'm gonna try to focus on mirrorless camera only. And as usual, I'm gonna split this review into two parts. It's gonna be cons and pro of this gimbal, so let's go. So the first pro is gonna be improved quality and design of this gimbal. If you guys look at this, I mean, the whole entire gimbal doesn't even look like Crane M2 anymore. There's a lot of aluminum parts now, and the whole entire plastic, even, like, it's not like rickety rick, like kind of creaking kind of plastic. I mean, the whole thing is pretty solid, and I love the button improvements, especially this joystick, guys. So this joystick has almost like a gaming pad feel to it. You can press down a little bit or all the way down. So acceleration point between like pressing down a little bit versus a lot, you can definitely have a lot more control over your gimbal. And I freaking love this control wheel. Actually, this feels just like the DJI RC2 gimbal, but yeah, it's an improvement for sure. And I love how small this gimbal is, even though this supports like full frame cameras. So to give you a size comparison, I have Weibo S. And that's the size difference between Weibo S. So height-wise, about similar, but volume-wise, it's definitely much smaller. And I also have Weibo 2. And this is the size difference between Weibo 2. As you can see, yeah, this is definitely a little bit more backpack-friendly than Weibo 2. This is a little chunky boy over here. So speaking of backpack, if you get like the upgraded packages of Crane M3, it does ship with this little backpack. Like this backpack's pretty high quality, so I think Juwin's trying to make backpacks, guys. I mean, they should, because you got this like magnetic flap, you got pockets here, pockets there, a little zipper, and you have your main compartment here. This is where your gimbal will go. It's like, yeah, this is a really well-made backpack, guys. I mean, like, texture is kind of like the leather. I will personally not be using this backpack, but I'm definitely gonna be just chucking this in my camera bag and ready to go. And second thing I like about this gimbal is one of the innovation, and that is this thing right here. This here is an LED light. Now, we've seen this before on a Juwin's phone gimbal, so I'm very excited to see that transfer over to a mirrorless camera gimbal. And this thing here is pretty bright. This is 800 lumens, guys. It's almost like a little mini projector. But what I like about this even more is that this is a high quality CRI 90 plus video light that is bi-color. So you got your daylight and the tungsten. And I did have to test to see if this was gonna flicker, because you know how low quality LED light just always constantly flickers. So I did try on a slow-mo motion, 120 frames per second with the proper shutter speed, and it does not flicker, so that's a plus. And as you've seen that in the video, you can actually change color of the LED lights, because they have these little magnetic, look at this, guys, it just sticks right there. Definitely not RGB, but it's nice to see that they did think about changing the colors via these little gels. And last thing I like about this LED is that you can see the status of the LED from the actual screen of the gimbal, which is really nice, because you don't have to like turn the gimbal around and try to look at the front. It's like, is it lit? Is it bright? Like, what level is it? Yeah, you don't have to guess that. You can see it from the screen. Which brings me to the third thing I like about this gimbal is this 1.22 inch touchscreen that's right at the front. It is bright enough so you can see it during the daylight. And what I do appreciate is that they did not actually lose this M button. This M button is the mode button to cycle through your gimbal modes like pan, follow, POV, and it's very important, which I'm gonna talk about a little bit later in the video. But yeah, I love the fact that you can either go through the screen to change the modes or just push this button right here. So the fourth thing I like about this gimbal is the quick release plate. Actually, it's a love and hate relationship because I love it and at the same time, and we'll talk more about it in the cons section. But this essentially is the quick release plate, guys. This is the original one, and the way you quick release is that there's a little knob here and you unlock it and you push down this red trigger and you push that and the whole thing releases. This is very similar to the Crane M2 quick release plate. So when you install this onto your camera, it does block out that battery compartment. So what Juwon has done is they also have these custom quick release plates. I told them that I have Sony A7S III and I just found out that this also supports Sony A7 III. So, okay, that's one thing I did not like. So this screw, yeah, you have to make sure you hold down to the bottom, otherwise it falls out. But, you know, little details. This fits perfectly onto the camera Sony A7S III. And the way this works is that because it's so tiny, the battery compartment on your camera is not blocked out. So you're able to release the camera from the gimbal and change out the battery if you have to. Unlike previous generation, yeah, that was kind of pain in the butt. All right, what number are we on? Five? Okay, fifth thing I like about this gimbal is the fact that this thing supports full frame mirrorless cameras and not any full frame. In fact, I saw in the list the compatibility, Canon R6 on that list. This is pretty impressive for a tiny little gimbal, and Sony A7S III is not a little skinny boy either. It's pretty chunky, but it handles it. Obviously, it depends on what kind of lens you use. So that's gonna be one of the cons I talk about later, but it does fit the actual camera in there with smaller lenses, and you can really start to tell the power of the gimbal when you do the POV mode. So yeah, turning to the left, to the right, yeah, I didn't feel like the gimbal couldn't handle it, so the motor didn't give up. So in terms of smoothness, it's a pretty smooth gimbal with the, I would have to put like an asterisk, right? So it's, look, if you look at the arm of this thing, so longer the arm, it can compensate for your up and down movements more, and this thing is a T-Rex. I mean, like, so yes, the motor is strong, but you still gonna have to do your like ninja gimbal walk like Michael Jackson. Otherwise, yeah, it's gonna be a little bit shaky. So considering the size of this gimbal, I would say this is a fairly smooth gimbal, but not only does it smooth out your footage, it does have added functionality, which comes to sixth thing I like about this gimbal. I know, I like a lot of things about this gimbal. There's so many things going on, and that is gonna be this little module. This module has this 1/4-inch audio input. So your microphone can plug in here. And the way this module goes on is that it docks right here, and the whole thing is aluminum, so it's really tight. And just lock it in, and now your gimbal got a little upgrade. So I believe this is not gonna come with this base model, so you do have to get an upgraded version of this. So this is one of the innovations that I was mentioning. So this package comes with a freaking Shaka mic by Juwon. So I think this is the first microphone that Juwon make, and they did a pretty good job. I mean, this thing is solid. I wish I could describe it to you, but this is heavy. Like this whole thing, yeah, I don't want to break it, but yeah, it's solid metal. I mean, like, this could be a freaking weapon. Like, zoom. Yeah, I wish. Oh, so it does have an XLR output, and it's actually cardioid and hypercardioid microphone, and you can put a little AA battery in here. I'm gonna actually switch out. So currently I'm using Sennheiser MKE-600, very popular microphone, but yeah, let's see what this can do. Okay, I am switched over. So I have this microphone exactly the same height as the other one. In fact, everything is exactly the same. I am putting a limiter of -3 dB on it. So that's the only filter I'm putting on. I'm also wearing a lav mic as a backup in case this sounds like crap. So how does it sound? And right off the bat, if I'm looking at the level, it is a little bit lower than the Sennheiser. So Sennheiser, I think, is a little bit more like meant to be used in the distance. I think this is more like handheld, like close to your mouth kind of microphone. So I mean, maybe about like a foot away from my mouth right now. And the way this works is that they provide this really long cable. So one side is XLR, another side is 1/4-inch. And you would basically plug in the 1/4-inch to the bottom of your gimbal. And they have another output over here. So the audio goes into your camera. So yeah, straight up XLR into your camera from your gimbal. I know this is kind of like new and look kind of strange to begin with, but I could definitely see a couple instances where you might actually use this. Well, I'll talk about it at the end of this video and who this gimbal really is for. So those are the good things about this gimbal. Let's talk about the cons, aka the limitations of this gimbal that you should be aware of and how to kind of avoid them or work around them. So the first thing I don't like about this gimbal, and this is something I'm very passionate about, like every single gimbal, you know I'm gonna be talking about the quick release plate. So the quick release plate on this, I like it. Yes, I did talk about how I liked it, but also I have a problem with this because it is not Arca Swiss nor Manfrotto plate. So this is a proprietary Zhuin plate. Once you detach your camera, you can't really dock this onto a tripod. I mean, like, yes, like, I think what I'm gonna have to do and the workaround is gonna be, guys, is that because this gimbal is so small, what I'm doing is I'm going to put one of these Transmount quick release plate. So the tripods here are the mini tripods. So when I undock this thing, I'm just gonna put this whole entire thing on a tripod. I mean, just such a small thing, like just like a tripod head, right? At that point. So I wish this was Arca Swiss, and I think it's such an important thing because the one feature of this gimbal that you're gonna constantly use every single time is the quick release plate. Like no matter what you use on this gimbal, you're always gonna have to deal with that because you have to unmount and mount your camera. So that's gonna be one thing I don't like about this gimbal. Now, second thing I don't like about this gimbal is the small camera cradle space. Yes, you can put a full frame mirrorless camera on here, but these arms are teeny. So I did have trouble with this when I shot the wedding because wedding is kind of like run and gun, right? So I was trying to like balance my camera. So at the time I had Sony a7S III with 24mm 1.4 G Master, which is a pretty hefty lens, and that's gonna be like a little bit beyond the capability of this gimbal. So I had a hard time balancing that because the pitch motor is the one thing that's hard to balance, because once you point the camera up to see where the arm's at, you can't really point up because the eyepiece is gonna hit the back motor, and you can't point down because the lens is gonna hit the actual gimbal. So yeah, once you have a heavier lenses on, this is really hard to balance. And I feel like the arm, yes, they're pretty sturdy, and I appreciate how it's all aluminum, but there's a little bit of flex and give to it. So what you're gonna have to do is flush the camera all the way up to the gimbal, so it's actually having like one more point of contact. The bad part is that once you try to pull this lever, so yeah, that lever is gonna hit the part of the camera. So there's not a lot of room to wiggle with. Yes, I think the perfect camera setup is gonna be a smaller mirrorless camera. So all these Sony ZV series, and even like I saw in a picture, it was actually a GIF. It's a Sony A7C with Tamron 28-75mm, and it was completely clearing the back motor. So clearly, this is capable of carrying those cameras, but once you go to like Sony A7S III size, you have to be careful with the lens choices. So 55mm 1.8, that's kind of like the limit of the weight. So that one is 281 grams, so any lens that's heavier than 281 grams on a full-frame Sony A7S III, you have to be careful with it. So the third thing that is an issue for me, and I actually ran into this by accident, is this power button. Now most gimbal power button is flush against the actual body of the gimbal. This one, they try to make it convenient so it's easy to press down, and that's the problem, it's easy to press down. So I had a shoot one day and I put this in a backpack, and it was fully charged the night before, and when I pulled the gimbal out, it was dead. It's because the power button got pushed inside the backpack. And it's very easy to press. There's a little divot here, guys. So anything that pressed against this power button, it is gonna turn on this gimbal by accident. So Zhuin, on the next gimbal design, yeah, you're gonna have to make that flush. Otherwise, yeah, we're gonna just keep accidentally pressing it. And the fourth con is gonna be the built-in battery. I know it does make the whole entire gimbal feel really solid. Problem with it is gimbals, I like to have extra batteries if possible, just like in case like we accidentally turn it on, or it just makes me feel better on a video shoot when I know that there's a detachable battery. So that's gonna be one of the cons. However, this does support the 25 watt PD quick charge, so you can quickly charge it. And the battery lifespan on this is rated at 8 hours, which I wasn't able to like use it 8 hours straight to be able to test it, but you know, during a regular shoot all day, it was just fine. So the insurance workaround for that issue is gonna be the fact that this gimbal does allow you to charge it while you use it, so that's a plus. So the last con of this gimbal is actually because we got spoiled by Crane M2. So the Crane M2 had this awesome innovation, right? So it was able to connect to your camera wirelessly to control your camera, which is like super cool because it remembers exactly like the connection of that previous connection, and you don't even have to like reconnect it. No wires necessary to control your camera. It was beautiful. So I thought they were gonna go somewhere with that, and I never saw that technology again. And I thought they were gonna like maybe bring it to Crane M3, but no, they did not bring it back. However, they do support this wireless control module. So this is the part that I can't test. And this is the part that the firmware currently is kind of like locking me out. So the setting for this control wheel is locked out right now, so I can't test it out even with the wire. But the idea is cool. So apparently they have this little wireless module that you plug into your camera, and you don't have to have the wire to control your camera. So when Jun sends me that, I'll definitely get to test out. And I think this is why this gimbal is very important, guys. So there's so many innovation on this gimbal. I feel like Jun is testing the ground and the water. So where are they gonna go with this? I'm very excited. I really, really hope to see this LED light come in like a full-size gimbal. Like, there's so many shoots I go in and I just wish like, oh, it's just a little too dark. I just want a little bit of light, and you know, my backpack somewhere else, I can't get the light. Yeah, you can't be like, Aziz, light. If you got that reference, you're cool. But yeah, you can't just like pull out a light out of nowhere, and this thing is gonna come clutch. I don't know what else I can add on, guys. I mean, like freaking laser, I'm not sure. So this gimbal, I think, is not for everyone, as in, I don't think this is gonna be the gimbal that you get as your only gimbal if you have a full frame sensor camera. I think this is a cool additional gimbal if you have a full-fledged like gimbal and you wanna get something small, and if you vlog a lot. So I can definitely see this being a really good vlogging setup because of that microphone input. I mean, that's special and unique. There's nothing else like it. And there's one niche I think I can see people using this. I can imagine like at CES, walking around with this like, you know, handheld microphone and someone following with the gimbal, and as they go around different booths, you know, someplace dark sometimes, turn that light on. Yeah, I think that would be perfect for like showroom, like event coverage kind of thing. And lastly, this gimbal is for someone who's trying to match your all white outfit.
Now I won't miss any of my shots. Oh crap. Oh. So clearly there's more discs coming. Follow me on Instagram for that, and thanks for watching to the end.